Hi, welcome to the episode 4 of our Azure Data Factory full course tutorial. In this session, we will create our first link service and we'll see how we can create it step by step using the Azure portal. I'm Deepak Goyal, having 12 years of experience, and I'm a certified Azure Solution Architect. I'll take you through this session where we will create the link services. Before beginning the video, I'll just repeat, if you haven't subscribed the channel, please do subscribe the channel so that you won't miss this exciting series of Azure Data Factory tutorial. Let's begin. So before creating the link service, let's do a one quick recap of what is link service. Link service is basically used to create the connection with your data source. In Azure Data Factory, most of the time you do a ETL, that is extract, transform, and load. So you connect to a one data source and try to move the data from one data source to the another data source. While talking to the data source, you need to connect to these data sources. And you can connect to these data sources using the link service. So that's why we need to have a link service in our Azure Data Factory. So let's see how we can create it. Using the Azure portal, you have to go to the Azure portal. And you have already, if you already have an Azure Data Factory account, you need to go to the Azure Data Factory account. If you don't have it, you can watch the video that is mentioned in the top link. There you will see how to create your first Azure Data Factory. We already have it, so I'm just clicking on my Data Factory. Click on Author and Monitor. This will take you to the Azure Data Factory. Here on the left hand side, you have a tab called as Manage tab. Just click on Manage tab. Here you can see there is a link service. You can just click on New to create your first link service. Now I want to connect to my Azure Blob storage. I already have an Azure Blob storage. Let's see how I can create a link service which connect to Azure Blob storage. You have to select the data source, data store that is your Azure Blob storage. Click on Continue. Now give your link service some name. Let's say I'll give link service for Blob. By default, you keep select this integration runtime as auto resolve integration runtime. Your authentication method would be account key. Just select your subscription where your Blob storage available. I'll select my own subscription. Then it will by default show you all the storage account available in that subscription. So select the required storage account. And that's all. You are almost ready to go. Just click on Test Connection to check the connection is successful. Yes, our connection is successful. And just click on Create. And your first link service is ready. I also have one Azure SQL database available with me. Now let's see how you can create a link service for Azure SQL database. So for that, again, click on New. It will, now this time you have to search for the Azure SQL because your link service want to connect to a SQL database. That's why you have to select the type as Azure SQL database. select and press continue. Now, it will ask you the name of a link service. Let's give link service for SQL DB. You again can keep the integration runtime as auto resolve integration runtime. Now, it will ask you your subscription. Select your subscription. If you have a valid Azure SQL database available under the subscription, it will be available in this dropdown. I have this server. I will select the database and it will ask me the SQL authentication. So I have defined a username and password. So I'll just give that username and password to connect to my Azure SQL database. Let's test the connection. The connection is successful. So just see one more time what we have given. We have given the server name, the database which we want to connect, and then we provided the username and password which connect to this server. Click on create and your link service is ready, which helps you to get and put the data from and inside the Azure SQL database. In this video, we already learned how to create the link service for your Azure Blob storage and for your Azure SQL database. Similarly, you can create the link service for your Databricks or for your MySQL database or MongoDB or any other database, just like selecting the correct type of link service you want to create and then provide the required information. So I hope you like the session. And if you are really liking it, please press the like icon and do subscribe the channel if you haven't subscribed it yet. So in the next video, we will see how we can create that data set using the link service which we created just now. So till then, keep learning, keep watching the video.